Good morning, students. Come to the class 7. P1 class 7. So, in the previous class, we discussed about the sine of the trigonometric functions. Sine of trigonometric. Sine of trigonometric functions. Regarding the two quadrants, first quadrant and second quadrants, we have discussed. See the students, this is a Cartesian plane. A plane is divided into four equal parts, first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, and fourth quadrant. In the four quadrants, we have to discuss the regarding the sine of the functions. We have discussed already regarding the first quadrant and second quadrants. I have to discuss the second quadrant examples. Second quadrant, some examples I have to discuss here. See the students, you know, all angles between 0 degree to 90 degree lies in the first quadrant. In the first quadrant, all angles lying between 0 to 90 degree. In the second quadrant, 90 degree to 180 degree, all angles lying between 90 degree to 180 degree. Let us see, in the second quadrant, we have taken a terminal line, it fall in the second quadrant, draw PM perpendicular on x-axis. Let us take P of x, y, b, any point in the terminal side of the line. Terminal side of the line. So you know OM is x, PM is y, OP is hypotenuse, always positive. In the second quadrant, x is negative, y positive, y is positive, and r always positive. R is always positive. Here the thing is that this x is only negative here. This is a right angle triangle. We have to discuss the trigonometric functions of all the trigonometric functions of this second quadrant. In the position of the second quadrant, we have to discuss here. So already you have seen sine theta is positive. Sine theta is positive. The reciprocal of sine cosecant theta is also positive. Tan theta is negative. Reciprocal of tan cot is also negative. Sec theta is positive or cos theta is positive. Cos theta is positive. Sorry, cos theta is negative. Cos theta is negative. The reciprocal of cos sec theta is also negative. So we have concluded in the previous class that the only sine theta and cosecant theta are positive in the second quadrant. Remaining all the trigonometric functions are negative. You know how it is. Because of sine is a y divided by r, both are positive. Cosec is a r by y, both are positive. But tan is y by x, here x is negative, therefore negative. Cot is x by y, this is negative. Cos is x divided by r. Sec is r by x, so therefore these four functions are negative in the second quadrant and the sine theta and cosecant theta are positives. Come to the, for example, sine of 110 degree, it is positive, it is positive angle, it is sine of 110 degree, sine of 110 degree is positive. Yes, clearly it is positive, students. But cos of 105 degrees is negative, student, because cos, sec, tan and cot are negative in the second quadrant. Only sine and cosecant are positive. And come to the student here, tan 400 and 400 and tan of 460 degree is it a positive or negative, students? Tan 460, let us come to the position of 460 degree. Let us come to the position of, first we have to identify the position of that angle 460. One complete revolution, it becomes 360 degree. Then this is one complete revolution. Then next, 360 plus 90, 450. 450 plus 10. In which quadrant it falls? In which quadrant it falls? It is in second quadrant. In the second quadrant, what about tan? Is it positive or negative? Negative it is. Tan 460 degrees, negative. Clear the students? I think it is clear all of you. Tan 460 I have taken, the student. 360, one complete revolution it is. 360 degree. So you want to draw 460 degree. You have to see the position of 460 degree. First you have to see the position of this angle. Position of the angle 460 degree. So 460 degree here I am taking here. 360 plus 90, 450. 450 plus 10, 460. So it is fall in the second quadrant. In the second quadrant, so sine and cosecant are positives, but it is tan. So therefore negative it is. I think clear this, these three examples. So we'll take one more example, student, here. Cosecant of 855 degree. Let us see the cosecant of 855 degree, student. See the cosecant of 855 degree. Let us, we will take the diagram, students, sir, that regarding the position of the angle here. So you know, one complete revolution it is 360, student. Two revolution 720. How much you want to draw? 855. See, 720 plus 90, 810. 810 plus how much? How much you want? So how much you want, student? 855 degree. See how much it becomes, friends? 855 degree. So where it fall 850 degree? What is the position of 855 degree, student? Second quadrant. So is it second quadrant? It is. Yes, it is second quadrant. How you have taken two complete revolution? It is one revolution 360. The two revolution 720. 720 plus 90. So 810. How much you want to take? 855. So how much you have to add? 45 degree. So that is in between 0 to 90. In between the 0 to 90 degree quadrants. So how much it becomes? 855 degree. What is the position of 855 degree? Second quadrant. Which function it is? Cosecant. Is it cosecant is positive or negative? Yes, positive it is. Like that, you have to identify the position of the angles. I think it is clear all of you, the students. I think it is clear all of you, students. One more example I will take, the student, here. One more example I will take, the student. What about sec of minus 210 degree? Negative angle I am taken. Negative angle taken, student, here. Secant of minus 210 degree. See the students here. Let us draw the 200 and negative of negative angle here. You know the negative angle, how to take the negative angle. So you know I have discussed in the first class, positive angle is taken as a anti-clockwise direction. Negative angle is taken as a clockwise direction. Let us take the clockwise direction, student, here. How much it is? 90, 180, 180 plus 30. How much it is, friends? 210 degree. How much it is? 210 degree. So what is the negative of minus 210 degree? Where it falls, friend? In the second quadrant. Is it clear all of you, the students, sir? It is a negative angle. Minus 90, minus 180, minus 180, minus 180, minus 30. It is minus 210 degree. It is minus of 210 degree. What is the position of this minus 210 degree, student? That is important. Identifying the position of the angle is important. So it is minus 210 degree. Which quadrant it is? Second quadrant. In the second quadrant, what about sec? Is it sec positive or negative? Sec is negative, student. So let us take these examples. You may take not only these angles, sir. You may take any angle student. Like that, you have to first identify the position of the angle, and then you write down their positive sign of the given function. So this is about the second quadrant, position of the second quadrant. This is examples I have not discussed in the previous class. Just I have discussed the example students. Now come to the third quadrant. Let us come to the third quadrant students. We'll go for the third quadrants. So the position of the third quadrant. Now see the third quadrant here. When the position of the angle is in third quadrant, let us have discussed afterwards some examples regarding the all the four quadrants with respect to four quadrants. See the students, we have discussed already two quadrants, that is first quadrant and second quadrants. In the first quadrant, the angles lie between 0 to 90 degree. In the second quadrant, the angles lying between 90 degree to 180 degree, in between 90 to 180 degree. Now come to the third quadrant. You know the students, in the third quadrant, this is the third quadrant, in the third quadrant after 180 degree, in between 180 to 270 degree, between 180 to 270 degree students, sir. The angles lying between 180 to 270 degree. This is the position of the angles. First you have to identify the position of the angles, either one time, one rotation, two rotation, three rotation, either positive angle or negative angle. See the students, sir, the terminal side of the angle rotates and fall in the third quadrant. Rotates and fall in the third quadrant. X-axis, Y-axis, X-axis and Y-axis. See, this is the terminal side of the. Let us take P of X, Y be any point in the terminal side of the angle. Draw PM perpendicular on X-axis. PM is perpendicular on X-axis. Clearly, you know, OM is a X distance. PM is a Y distance and OP is the R distance. This is the third quadrant. We have taken a triangle in the third quadrant. Let us take an angle theta. The terminal side of the angle rotates and fall in the third quadrant. I think the diagram is clear, all of you, the students here. I have taken the third quadrant. In the third quadrant, a triangle, right angle triangle. We need to study the sign of the trigonometry functions. Here x and y values are important. Here it depends upon x and y. In the third quadrant, I have taken a right angle triangle. So in the third quadrant, is it student, both x and y are negative? Clear all of you? Both x axis and y axis are negative. It is negative x axis, negative y axis. Y axis perpendicular, y axis, and x axis, it is negative. It is. So both x and y are negative. Both x and y are negative. What about r? R is always positive. Hypotenuse. So I have discussed the sign of the trigonometry functions depend upon sign of x and y. You should know the sign of these three of a right angle triangle, because the trigonometry functions are in terms of ratios of a sides of a right angle triangle. Here both x and y are negative, r is positive. Here you know the three sides. Here come to the one by one function. Here sine theta y divided by r, opposite by hypotenuse. Y is negative square, r is positive. The result is what here? Negative it is. Clear the students? So what it is? Sin theta is negative. Tell me the student, if sin is negative means, what about the cosecant theta? Reciprocal of sin is a cosecant theta. R by y, student, it is also the negative. Yes, because sin theta, y by r, cosecant theta, reciprocal of this value, r by y. You can take directly. If positive, sin theta is positive, cosecant is positive. If sin theta is negative, cosecant theta is negative because of the reciprocal functions. Now come to students, cos theta. What is cos theta? X divided by our adjacent side by hypotenuse. What is cos theta? Adjacent side by hypotenuse, that is x by r. What is x? X is always negative. X is a negative, sorry. R is always a positive. Negative by positive, the result is what? It is negative. Cos theta also negative, students. If cos is negative, what is the reciprocal of cos? Sec is also negative, student. Clear all of you, I think, student? If cos theta is negative, the sec theta is also negative, student. Yes? I think clear it is all of you, student, here. If cos is negative, the reciprocal of a cos, sec is also negative. Come to students here, last one. Tan theta. What is tan theta? Y divided by x. Opposite by hypotenuse. Opposite by hypotenuse, tan theta is a y by x. Y negative, x also negative, the result is positive. Negative by negative, positive it is. Yes, tan theta is positive. If tan is positive, what is the reciprocal of tan? Cot is also positive. Tan theta is positive. Reciprocal of tan theta? Cot theta. Cot theta is also positive. Clear all of you students here? Sine and cosecant theta are negative. Cos and secant theta are negative, but tan theta and cot theta are positive. So the students here, what you have concluded in the first quadrant? All positive. All positive. Sin theta and cosecant theta are positive. Remaining all are positive. So but here what you have concluded, student, here? Tan theta and cot theta are positive. Remaining all are negative. See the students here. Remaining all are negative. So the what you have concluded, student, here in the third quadrant, tan theta and cot theta are positive, remaining are negative. So here see the students here, in the first quadrant all the functions are positive. In the second quadrant, only sin theta and cosecant theta are positive. Like that, in the third quadrant, only tan theta and the tan reciprocal cot are positive, remaining are negative. Now see the comes to the example, students here. Come to the examples of some angles of this tan theta, cot theta here. So these trigonometry functions here. Let us see the students here. Sine of 210 degree is. Tell me, students, sir. Sine of 210 degree, where it comes here? So in the third quadrant position of the direct, it is. There is, yes, only one within a one revolution it is. Positive or negative, students, here. Sine is third quadrant, it is in the third quadrant. Sine is negative, therefore sine 210 degrees negative. I think clear, student, it is. Yes, come to the tan of 230 degree. Is it a positive or negative, student? Is it a positive or negative, students? Yes, positive. Is positive because of 230 degree. Direct it is, they know within a revolution, 230 degree, where it fall, the position of this angle is third quadrant, position of the 230 degree angle is third quadrant. So therefore it is positive because in the third quadrant tan and cot are positive and remaining all are negative. Clear, the students here? Yes. Now come to the cosecant of 565 degree. See the students, sir. How much it is? We have taken 565 degree. See the students, 360 degree one complete revolution. 360. Yes. Sorry, 360. All right, correct. It is 360 plus 360 plus 90, 450. 450 plus 90. 450 plus 90. How much? 540. Is it a 540? So 450 plus 90 degree. Clear, all of you? 530 degree. 530 degree. How much you want to draw? 530 degree plus 35 degree. Where is the position of this 565 degree, student? Third quadrant. Is it in the position of this angle is third quadrant, student? See, once again the students here, one complete revolution 360 up to this, one complete revolution 360. 360 plus 90, 450. 450 plus 90, 4, see, this is up to 360. 360 plus 90, 450. 450 plus 450 plus, sorry, 450 plus of 450 plus of 90 degree, how much students here? 540, sorry, 540. 540 plus 25 degree, how much it is? First, 565 degree, want to draw? 565 degree. What is the 565 degree position of the 565 degree, students? So, third quadrant. Tell me, is it in the third quadrant? Are you getting the position of this angle here? Yes, this is the position of the angle is 565 degree. What is the position here? Third quadrant. So, in the third quadrant, what are positive? Tan and cot are positive. Which function you have taken? Cosecant. Is it a positive or negative student? Yes, it is a negative students. Clear, I think, the students? Yes, it is a negative. Now, come to the next angle. Sec of, see the next angle here. Sec of 925 degree. 925 degree. See the students here, position of this angle. 360, 720, 720 plus 90, 810, 810 plus 90, 900 exactly, 900 plus 25 degree, whatever it may be. What is the position of this angle, student? What is the position of the angle here, 925 degree, student? Third quadrant. Is it in the third quadrant? Sec positive or negative? Sec positive or negative, student? Negative it is. Only tan and cot are positive. Sec is negative. So therefore, the position of this angle is third quadrant. See the students, for these two angles, first you should identify the position of the angle with one rotation, two rotation, whatever it may be. So this is what here, 565 degree. It is also the third quadrant. 925 degree, it is also the third quadrant. So therefore, sec is negative. Clear the students here? So this is about the third quadrant. Here I am taking functions with their particular positions of the angles. Is it clear? One more example I will take, the students. One more example I will take, very simple here. Cot of 110 degree. Tell me the students. Sorry, cot of minus of 110 degree, student. In the rotation of clockwise, tell me the student, in the rotation of clockwise, 110 degree in the rotation of clockwise, minus 90, how much it is? Minus 90, minus 20, 110 degree. What is the position of this cot? Minus of 110 degree, student. Third quadrant. In the third quadrant, positive or negative? Cot is positive, therefore it is positive. Not only these three particular angle, students, you may take any angles. So you may identify their position first. Like that, you may identify their position first and then you come to the sign. So according to the respect of the sign, so sign, it is a negative in the third quadrant, 210 degree, 230 degree, third quadrant, positive it is, 565 degree, third quadrant, cosecant is there, it is a negative, 925 degree, just we have seen, third quadrant, so therefore it is also a negative. So, but cot of minus 110 degree, the position of negative angle, minus of 110, it is fall in the third quadrant, is fall in the third quadrant, their cot is positive. So this is about the sign of the function with the third quadrant. So these are the some examples of the third quadrant. What we have concluded in the third quadrant, students, tan theta and cot theta are positive. These are the with respect to of some sample examples of the third quadrant position of the angles. So this is about the third quadrant. This is about the third quadrant. Come to the fourth quadrant. See the students, this is about the third quadrant. Come to the fourth quadrant, last one, that is the position of the fourth quadrant. Yes, come to the fourth quadrant, students. Now, yes, we know this is the first quadrant, 0 to 90 degree, second quadrant, 90 to 180 degree, third quadrant, 180 to 270 degree, and in the fourth quadrant, 270 to 360 degree. This is about the fourth quadrant. This is the position of the angles in between 270 to 360 degree. So with the revolutions also you have to check. Let us see the fourth quadrant, students, sir. The fourth quadrant angles, the fourth quadrants. In the fourth quadrants, the terminal of the side, terminal of the angle is fall in the fourth quadrant. See the students here, the fourth quadrant position here, the terminal side of the angle rotates and fall in the fourth quadrant. Fall in the fourth quadrant. See the students, fourth quadrant here, the terminal side of the angle. You can take OP is the terminal side of the angle here. Terminal side of the angle. This is an angle theta here. Is an angle theta it is. Yes. See the students. An angle theta it is. Fourth quadrant. Let it makes an angle theta. Let us draw PM perpendicular on x-axis. PM is perpendicular on x-axis. Let us take P of x comma y be any point on the terminal side of the angle. This is a right angle triangle in the fourth quadrant. I have taken in the fourth quadrant. Is it a right angle triangle? Well, let us see. You know, OM is a x distance, PM is a y distance, OP is always positive. See the students, this is in the right angle triangle. It is in the third quadrant. It is in the third quadrant. So here, right angle triangle, you need a right angle triangle to see the position of the angles. This is the position of the third quadrant, students. Position of the third quadrant, it which makes an angle theta. Which makes an angle theta it is. Let us see, here you know the positions of the angles here. It is OM, PM and OP are the three sides here. So clearly here OM is on positive x axis, x positive, x is positive here, x is positive. What about y? Tell me the students, y is negative, y is negative student. Y is a negative. What about R? R is positive always. We have discussed R is positive. You know the students, the sign of the function depend upon sign of x and y. The sign of the function depend upon sign of x and y. R always positive it is. R is always positive. See the students, sin theta is equal to, we'll go for the one by one the with the functions. Sin theta is a y divided by r. Tell me the students, y is what here? Negative it is. R is positive. What is the result? Negative it is. Yes. So the students, sin theta in the first quadrant positive, in the second quadrant positive, but in the third quadrant and fourth quadrant negative it is. Come to the reciprocal of the function, cosecant theta is also negative. If sin is negative, the reciprocal of sin theta, cosecant theta is also negative, students. Come to the students, cos theta. What is cos theta? X by r, student here. Cos theta is x by r, adjacent side by hypotenuse. With respect to this right angle triangle, cos theta is x by r. What is x? Positive, student. R always positive. What is the result? Yes, positive it is. See, here in the fourth quadrant, cos theta is positive. In the third quadrant, tan theta is positive. In the second quadrant, sin theta is positive. But in the first quadrant, all are positive. Remember, you should remember like that, students. In the first quadrant, all are positive. But in the second quadrant, sin theta and cosecant theta are positive. Remaining all are negative. In the third quadrant, tan theta and cot theta are positive. Remaining all the functions are negative. But in the fourth quadrant, what you are getting? Cos theta is positive. What is the cos reciprocal, student? Sec theta. Sec theta is also positive. So the students, cos and sec are positive. Now see the last one, tan theta. What is tan theta, students? Y by x. Y divided by x, opposite by adjacent side. Is it y positive or negative here? Y is negative, but x is positive, but the result is negative. See the students, if tan is negative means, what is the tan reciprocal, students? Cot. Cot also negative, students. So come to the conclusion here. See the students here, sin theta and cosecant theta are negative, tan theta and cot theta are negative, but cos theta and sec theta are positive. Sin theta and cosecant theta are negative, tan theta and cot theta are negative, but cos and sec are positive. So what you concluded here, students, in the fourth quadrant? Cos theta and sec theta are positive. Remaining all the functions are negative. So in the first quadrant, all positive. Second quadrant, sin theta and cosecant theta are positive. Third quadrant, tan theta and cot theta are positive. But in the fourth quadrant, cos and sec are positive. With respect of these three, remaining all are negatives. With respect of these four quadrants, remaining all are negatives. But in the first quadrant, all the functions are positive. All the functions are positive. Now see the students. Let us will go for the examples. Once again, I recall, in the first quadrant, all are positive. In the second quadrant, sine and cosecant are positive, remaining all are negative. Remember, students. And in the third quadrant, tan theta and cot theta are positive, remaining all are negatives. And in the fourth quadrant, cos and sec are positive, remaining all the functions are negative. Remaining all the functions are negative. Now see the students, come to this. Examples of these fourth quadrant, positions of the angles first. Now see the students, sine of 330 degree. Tell me, student, position of 330 degree, fourth quadrant. In the fourth quadrant, sine positive or negative? Negative. It is negative. Clear the students? Sine of 330 degree is negative. Tell me, students, cos of 350 degree. Cos of 350 degree. Position of 350 degree? Fourth quadrant. In the fourth quadrant, cos is positive. It is positive. Yes? Yes? Clear all of you, the students here? Yes, it is a positive. Now come to the students here. Tan of 305 degree is, what about the position of 305 degree, students? It is in the position of fourth quadrant. The angle fall in the terminal side of this angle fall in the fourth quadrant. The terminal side of 350 degree fall in the fourth quadrant. 330 degree also fall in the fourth quadrant. So in the fourth quadrant, is it tan positive or negative, students? Negativity is. Now see the students here. Come to the next one. Tell me, cot of 675 degree. What about cos of 675 degree? Let us check the students here. Cos of 675 degree, 360 degree, one complete revolution. 360 plus 90, 450, 450 plus 90, 530, 530, how much here? 530 plus 90, 530 plus 90, 620, 620 plus, 620 plus of how much you want to draw? 75, it is 65, 75 now? Yes, 55 it is. Where it falls to the terminal side of 675 degree, students? 675, where it falls, it is. So in the fourth quadrant, once again we'll check 620, how much it becomes. See, 360 it is. 360 plus 90, 450, 450 plus 90, 530, 530 plus 90, 610. Once again, we'll check the students here. Yes, there is a, don't confuse. 360 it is, one complete revolution. 360 plus 90, 450, 450 plus 90, 450 plus 90, 540, 540 plus 90, 540 plus 90, 630 it is. Students, sorry, 630 plus 45 degree, 675 degree. So what is the position of this 675 degree, students? What is the position of 675 degree? Fourth quadrant. In the fourth quadrant, what about cot? Is negative. Like that, you have to see their position, students. Like that, you have to see the positions of this angle, friend. Is it clear, I think, friend? Yes, is it clear, all of you, this one? Yes. Now come to the next one here. Yes. Now let us take one more example here. Yes. Cosecant of 1025 degree. Cosecant of 1025 degree. See the students. Cosecant of 1025 degree. Yes. Cosecant of 1025 degree. 360 plus 360, 720 degrees, student. 720 plus 90, 810. 810 plus 90, 900. 990. How much it is? 990 plus 35 degree. This is 1025 degree, student. 1025 degree. What is the position of this angle? 1025 degree, student. Fourth quadrant. In the fourth quadrant, cosecant positive or negative? It is negative. It is negative. Now come to the last example, student. Come to the last one more example I will take. Tell me the position of which one remaining here, student. So sec is remaining. I will take, what about sec of 5 degree, student? What about sec of minus 5 degree? Positive or negative? Secant of minus 5 degree. Secant of minus 5 degree. See the students here. What is the position of this one? Negative angle it is. It is in the fall in the which quadrant? Fourth quadrant. In the fourth quadrant, what about cos and sec? Positive strengths it is. Is it a positive? Yes, positive it is. Only cos and sec are positive. Remaining all are negative. So these are the some examples of the fourth quadrant there. So here the students, first identifying the position of the angles is important. Then after identifying the position of their positions, standard angles in the positions of these angles, and then you go come to the functions here, students. See sine, cos, tan, cot, whatever it may be. So if the angle is fall in the first quadrant, you say all are positive. If the angles are fall in the second quadrant, if it is sine and cosec, you write positive. If the angles are fall in the third quadrant, if it is tan and cot, you write positive. If it is remaining, you take negative. If it is cos and sec, you can take right to the positives. Remaining all are negative. So this is about some examples of the fourth quadrants. Some examples of the fourth quadrant. Now I come to the conclusion of this sign of the trigonometric functions. How to remember all these? How to remember the fourth quadrant? Yes. First quadrant, third quadrant, whatever it may be. Yes. You remember this formula, you will come to know the students. So what you have studied up to this one here, students, sir? So sign of the trigonometric functions we have taken. So first quadrant, the angles 0 to 90 degree. Second quadrants, 90 to 180 degree, second quadrant. Third quadrant, 180 to 270 degree, 180 to 270 degree. In the fourth quadrant, 270 to 360 degree. This is the positions of the angles here, all the four. First quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, and fourth quadrant. So all are positive means all the trigonometric functions are positive here in the first quadrant. You know, you have some examples after 360 rotation, but it should be 0 to 90 degree. And in the second quadrant, sine theta and cosecant theta are positive. Remaining all are negative. And in the third quadrant, tan theta and cot theta are positive. Remaining all are negative. And in the fourth quadrant, just you have taken. And in the fourth quadrant, sec theta and there is cos theta, reciprocal of cos, sec. Cos and sec are positive. Remaining all are negative. See the students, you should remember this chart, students, here. Then you will come to know the students. If you remember this one, then you will come to know all the functions at a time. See, this is the, I have taken the plane, student, x-axis, y-axis, Cartesian plane. Here I am taking the position of the first quadrant, second quadrant, first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, and the fourth quadrant, students. here I will write in the first quadrant position A. A stands for all the functions are positive. A. Here I am taking S. S stands for sine. Sine reciprocal, cosec are positive. S is sine. The reciprocal of sine here, cosec. All are positive. Sec and cosec are positive, but remaining all are negative. Come to the third position, I will take the students T. T stands for tan. Tan reciprocal, cot is positive and remaining all are negative. C here I am taking in the fourth quadrant, in the fourth quadrant here I am taking C. So cos theta and sec theta are positive, remaining all the functions are negative. Remaining all the functions are negative. So this is what ASTC rule. This is what ASTC rule. See the students here, ASTC rule, all positives. All the functions are positive, sine and cosecant theta are positive, remaining all the functions are negative, tan and cot are positive, remaining all are negative. C stands for what is cos, now cos and sec are positive, remaining all the trigonometric functions are negative. So this is about the positions of the standard angle strands. Positions of the standard angles, ASTC rule. A stands for all are positive in the first quadrant. S stands for sine theta, sine reciprocal of sine theta, cosecant theta. Sine and cosecant are positive in the second quadrant. T is one, means what it is? Tan reciprocal cot. Tan and cot are positive in the third quadrant. And C, cos and sec are positive in the fourth quadrant, and remaining all are negative. So this is about the sign of the trigonometry functions. Remember this rule, student, ASTC rule. ASTC rule. If you remember this one, you will come to know the all the functions about the trigonometry functions, all the functions, students here. The sign of all the functions. So this is about the sign of the trigonometry functions. Okay, student, today I conclude the class. This is about the sign of the trigonometry functions. Thank you. I will continue in the next class. Some examples on the sign of the trigonometry functions. Once again, I will, in the next class, I will go for all the examples of all the four quadrants in the next class, and then some 4 marks and 5, 3 marks and 5 marks examples we will take in the next class, students. Thank you.